Asian markets kicked off a new trading week mostly higher. This is as they got the chance to react to Friday's better-than-expected jobs data from the U.S., which eased fears of a recession in the world's biggest economy. Japan's Nikkei 225 led gains with a rally of 1.8%. The Hong Kong Hang Seng also among top performers, with the index hitting the 23,000 level for the first time since February 2022. The Hang Seng has rallied for about 2 weeks now after the Chinese government announced a slew of stimulus measures since late September. The PSEI also marking a milestone, with the main index closing above 7,500 for the first time in 2 years.
It's still a good chance to come in, but admittedly, the best time to have bought more, if you weren't in it, was before the first rate cut, right? Mm. Because we were at the 6.7, 6.8 levels. Now you have to be really selective on what you'll buy, because there might be less aggressive swings already. But then, as you know, people are still taking profits, so you just you trade on the swings. But in general, a lot of the corporates, at least parang bumalik na yung dating valuation nila.
A notable stock movement in the region, Nintendo shares surged 4.5% in Monday trade. That's after Saudi Arabia's sovereign wealth fund said it is considering raising its holdings in Japanese gaming companies.
Here's some local corporate headlines. Cebu Pacific acquires boutique airline AirSwift from Ayala Land Capital for 1.75 billion pesos. The deal will add 5 turboprop aircraft to the fleet of the Gokongwei's budget carrier. AirSwift focuses on domestic routes to destinations, such as El Nido, Cebu, Boracay, and Bohol. Meanwhile, a consolidation of MegaWorld's top brass, as Kevin Tan is appointed board member and executive director of the property firm. He will be taking the reins from his mother, Catherine Tan, who stepped down today. The 45-year-old Kevin Tan previously served as executive vice president and chief strategy officer. And finally, Dito CME clarifies it is seeking to move to a later date its follow-on offering to give potential investors more time to evaluate the opportunity. Davao businessman Uy's telco firm plans to offer up to 1.95 billion common shares at any price between 1 peso to 2 pesos and 15 centavos apiece. Dito is expected to raise up to 4.2 billion pesos from the offering.
Billionaire tycoon Elon Musk makes his first appearance at a Trump campaign. Speaking at a rally in Pennsylvania where Trump was nearly assassinated last July, Musk urged the crowd to register and vote, saying the Republican candidate must win to preserve democracy.
The true test of someone's character is how they behave under fire. And we had one president who couldn't climb a flight of stairs, and another who was fist pumping after getting shot. Fight, fight, fight. Blood coming down the face. Now, America is the home of the brave. And there's no truer test than courage under fire. So that, who do you want representing America? Yeah, absolutely. President Trump must win to preserve the Constitution. He must win to preserve democracy in America. Yes. This is a must-win situation.
Meanwhile, in a separate rally, Trump said he would slap tariffs as high as 200% on vehicles imported from Mexico. That's double from his previous promise as he ramps up his protectionist trade rhetoric ahead of the November 5 elections.